volt, fiúk? Úgy nézem, jégbe hűtött sushi a reggeli.
Snickering, floppy-eared hound. When courage is needed, you're never around. Those medals you wear on your moth-eaten chest should be there for bungling at which you are best. So stop the pigeon, 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 stop the pigeon. Ow! Jam him, jam him, jam him, grab him, stop that pigeon now! You, Zilly, stop sneaking. It's not worth a chance, for you'll be returned by the seat of your pants. And Clunk, you invent me a thingamabob that catches that pigeon or I lose my job. So, stop the pigeon, 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 stop the pigeon.
The following story is 100% true. It involves an unlikely hero emerging from the direst of circumstances. How do you call for help if you're surrounded and trapped in enemy territory? This was the question for the US 77th, the Lost Battalion, trapped in a French forest during World War I. They are surrounded by the Germans, but no one knows that they're in trouble. With casualties mounting, they desperately need to get a message back to headquarters.
Communication is probably one of the most, if not the most important thing that you have to have on the battlefield.
During the First World War, communication on the battlefield was a very, very hard thing to do. Under normal circumstances, what they did was they strung wire communication, telephone wire.
But these are not normal circumstances. Their only hope for survival lies in the hands of a high-precision airborne delivery system, the Pigeon. Pigeons are born with an innate internal compass that lets them navigate the Earth's magnetic field.
This is done through special cells that contain tiny little magnets. And in the case of birds, these are either located in the brain or in part of the beak.
In World War I, pigeons were often used as couriers to send long-distance messages.
And of course, the Germans knew that these pigeons carried messages and they became targets.
One by one, the winged warriors of the 77th get picked off by the Germans. Finally, just one is left, named Cher Ami, French for dear friend. He sets off across the killing ground. Gets shot in the breast, blinded in one eye. His leg hangs on by just the tendon, but he does not stop. Finally, Cher Ami staggers into U.S. Army headquarters. His message saves the Lost Battalion from destruction. Cher Ami is fitted with a wooden leg and declared a great American hero. He is sent stateside by U.S. General John J. Pershing, having saved the lives of 194 men.
There's something called the Dickens Medal, which is awarded to animals for bravery. And the animals that have been awarded the most Dickens Medal are pigeons.
Cher Ami.
guerra sin final. El recuerdo del ayer nos queda frío y duro pa'l cristal. Ya nada será igual. Es un juego nada más. No hay un ganador. Por el cielo van sin sentir ningún temor. Flying hero. Cámara pasó en pleno vuelo. Flying hero. Su misión consiste en ir directo.